him.
Oh, yeah, here she was sticking her whole hand in her mouth.
Two other notes about the polar situation. Lech Wałęsa, the independent union leader, called again today
for a
confrontation between the union and Polish authorities. The way to change in Poland is to keep on pushing. From Moscow tonight, an announcement which may even the Soviet music.
Ta-da!
That worked. Why'd you open it? You said you could.
Yeah. You just put that little thing down to that cork and you're good. And out it comes. How about that now? If that isn't innovative, I don't know what it is.
Have a bite.
Hello, Ms. Moore.
Whitney.
Nuclear weapons. He said Poland is in serious danger of being invaded and backed up that assessment with pictures of spy satellites. Detente is dead. Quote, if movement from the Cold War to detente is progress, then let me say we cannot
afford
progress. And while Soviet leader Leonid Brezhnev in Czechoslovakia was calling for immediate arms control talks, Weinberger said the U.S. was in no hurry to begin such negotiations. That's not a view welcomed by Western
Chancellor
Helmut Schmidt, who met with Weinberger in the German newspaper.
You hungry?
Russian soon or face serious problems in U.S.-West German relations. Officials say
the don't spit.
That
concentrated on clearing up some minor problems. NASA officials say they are still aiming for Friday launch with a few rebels. We'll have the full story. Also still ahead, we've got a few questions. President Reagan to talk about the shooting. Abby Hoffman gets 3 years in jail.
ABC's World News Tonight is brought to you by Oil of Olay.
Hold your arm up. Hold it up. Hold your arm up. Hold it up.
Discover the mystery of oil and it can help you make younger too.
You haven't eaten your supper. You must eat the rest of your supper.
But this is where it all began for Midas.
Stick out your t-
Yeah? Can you not get that?
Come here.
Where'd she go?
She goes out the hall and puts her hand. That heat's off, Amy.
Yeah.
Well, she put her hand on that rest, you know, and then she put it back up.
It's hot. Whitney.
Come here.
Uh-huh.
Where did she go?
She's in here.
What a lively group to take pictures of.
If you had that running around all the time, you couldn't.
Let's go down to the funeral home now and get some action in here.
Something hard. I can help. Believe me. You I could jump that.
Didn't you hit Ms. Nicholson one time? When somebody reached up and did like that, didn't you hit her? Miss Nicholson.
Yeah.
And in the bottom.
She was in front of him and somebody walked up behind him and did like that to his ribs and daddy hit her.
Did she hit you back?
Would you like me to pose?
You just see her in the nursery. She got, there was this really old bear in there, a big thing, bigger than her. She took it and threw it down on the floor and straddled it and beat on it. And
like she did with a gorilla.
I see you whistle.
She did that with that gorilla.
Well, it was like wrestling with it. But it was about her size.
But see granddaddy.
Hey, now that would be something cute to make her picture with.
Watch where you're going there now.
Honey, you're going to fall.
I'm afraid she's
going to
hit her head on
the corner. You're running. I'm going to sit down. He thinks that's a drawer, but it's not.
Look at granddaddy, Whitney.
Whitney.
Look up here.
Whistle.
Smile at granddaddy there.
Whistle.
No.
Whistle, Whitney. No.
Thing
you
miss
touch your
thing in the world.
Now she looks like
Joe. Now leave it right there. Don't pull it off. Whitney?
I didn't tell you, did you? Here, Whitney. Here. I know you can carry that.
Just tear that to ribbons. Just get all of it.
Come here, carry this. Go now. Go. Wait a minute. That's heavier than you.
Like I say.
Uh-oh.
That's what God made niggers for. Okay, for those people's kids.
Joe, you're
going to
smack.
It hit from me.
Did I say that into the microphone clear now? Do I need to repeat that tomorrow?
Scatter.
Hey, Lord, I can't
drink it up.
And Clyde, you'll be so embarrassed when you hear all the terrible things
you
say.
Yeah, I sound like that little girl.
She's gone. You can turn it off.
Get Granny, get a close-up shot of Granny wiping her nose.
That would be real good. First.
Winter, that
meal
have to watch it when it comes out.
Uh-huh.
She knows about hot though.
Yeah, she, that's how come her feeling at first, I believe. She'd lay her hand over it, and then she'd go on over.
Thank you.
forgot to say that this is Sunday, April the 12th, 1981, on Sunday.
Who's running the car?
Is it Granny Fisher? Is it Granny Fisher?
What are you doing?
Gotta shake you up, Granny.
I'm new young barber for the big bud.
Whitney, 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 oh Whitney, I believe you better not. Huh?
Yeah.
Listen to the jingle. Oh, look. Yeah, that's good. Come on, Dan. You're the mighty rush to the engine grind, lots of the holes. Come on. We're traveling through to Dixie on the Wabash.
Hey.
Bye. 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 Bye.
Whitney.
Bye. I got you. Got you. You gonna dance with me? Let's dance.
Whole box car.
That's good. Whitney. Bye bye.
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 Bye. Whitney. Bye bye. Bye. Bye.
Got you. Got you. Now let's move to the window. Let's move over to the window and see if it photographs better. Don't blow them in the ears, you know. Get hungry. She's getting hungry. Is it getting hungry? So y'all look at Grandma.
Hey, Grandma.
Hey, Grandma. Hey, Grandpa.
You hungry?
Hey, Whitney. Bye.
David, experiment with this going out the window and see what happens. I bet that thing will handle it.
You reckon?
Yeah, go toward the thing here. Let me get near the window. But gotcha.
You're busy
while
they
look at
that
picture, man.
Beautiful.
Huh? Pretty? Yeah, that's pretty, girl. Let's go see Grandpa. Go see Grandpa. Say, hey, Grandpa.
Not unless you're
going to be excited. Can I bet him to say? Okay. What you want?
What's the date?
April the 18th, 1981.
Saturday.
Saturday.
Day before morning. Easter.
Day before Easter. In between Good Friday and Easter.
I see some old ladies back there in the background.
Bad again. I didn't hear it all.
Boxcar.
Boxcar? Listen to the jingle. Rumble and the roar. Rides along the woodland to the hills and by the shore.
Doing all good.
In the mighty rush of the engine, that lonesome hobo called. Riding through the woodland on the Wabash cannonball.
Whitney, how old did we say you were today?
1 year.
1 year.
1 month.
1 month.
9 days.
9 days. That's getting old.
About 2 o'clock a day.
No. 6 o'clock tonight.
6 o'clock
tonight.
8 and 3 quarters
of the day. No. Throw it down.
Throw it down.
No, don't put it in your mouth. Get your finger out of your mouth. You choked to death. No.
You want to have your picture in your Easter basket? This was Mommy's Easter basket. I want to take a picture of it.
Hi, Whitney. Boom.
That's what I say, ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
Don't you wish you could get your foot in your mouth that easy?
Wish I could sit down and get up like she does,
too. Yeah, really.
No, don't bite the glass. Here's a poke. Don't bite on the glass.
Want some water?
Hi, Whitney. Hi, that's nice.
That was sweet. Will you throw me a kiss? Thank you.
Will you throw me one?
Throw Granddaddy a kiss. Throw Granddaddy a kiss. Throw it to him. Say.
Thank you.
Doggy, you stop at every blade of grass and point. Whitney. Whitney. Darling. The pretty flowers.
Hi, Whitney. It's Sunday, April the 26th, 1981, just so we'll remember the date. Whitney.
Guess where we're going? We're going to go to Greenville.
Grandma and Granddaddy Rollins' house. Is that a bug on your head?
Hi, Whitney, what have you got?
Flower.
You picked your tooth.
It's just like those cameras they carry around and put it on TV.
Oh, my goodness.
You go to be at the airport somewhere, they'll come through and try to make you talk, you know?
Yeah.
Tell them your history, Flight's history.
Oh. Mr. Rollins had one of those. Davey couldn't stand it till he came.
Well, I don't blame him.
Well, that's probably granddaughter.
I tell you, I reckon this generation, they just live and get third raise the best way they can. Now listen to this. And then they look forward to everything for the grandchildren. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
You agree, didn't you? Now, Carmen and Bessie, they went up to Bill Coggins and they had, Delis had this, I think Carly bought one of the insurance suit from him. He went back up there last week and got another one. He's fixing that for that young one of theirs. Said, put down, if he fixed it, put down the basement. When he got married, he had it.
Carl Jones.
Did we tell you about Carl Jones coming up?
Yeah.
Well, Terry started, Joseph, I called him David 2/3 of the time. She started him a bank account at Christmas, and everybody put a little money in.
Well, if you add on to it, as long as it's in the
Christmas time.
Well, time to go to college, you'll have a whole lot of it. Yeah.
We started her birthday, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and she started it at Christmas.
Those pictures are good.
I'll be in, because
well, she likes it.
This family of fires.
Well, I've already.
You're in, huh?
Done a lot of my day. We ain't done ours, have we?
That's right.
He's trying to get me looking.
No.
He's been here getting it all assembled.
Oh, Jack has something like that. You talk, then he'll talk it back to you. What's that recording?
Microphone picks up everything.
I'd like for other people to see me. How about that boy that's trying for killing that old lady? Eugene, they give him enough?
Well, no, they didn't. Billard killed him.
That's what Billard done.
Well, now they gave him a pretty good sentence, though, didn't they?
Yeah.
How much they gave him, Eugene? I heard.
50.
50 to 60 years, yeah. Our paper said.
He would have got life, no pardon, that's what he would have got.
Yeah.
Now that boy get out, I believe it's 20 years, he'll get parole.
Maybe before then.
Yeah. Well, the other night they talked, they said they had to turn a lot of them prisoners out. We had to turn them out of the penitentiary.
George, you look pretty good.
Don't take my picture lying squatted down like that.
Oh. Yeah. That would make a good picture.
Yeah, that's right.
You don't have them, no one in this world in a mess, boy. And when they give them guys 20, 30 years, why they never work a lick, they just sit in jail all the time, they never work a lick, do nothing. That's the reason these guys don't care to get time. They don't do nothing to sit around and watch television. Their time, that's all they do.
Yeah.
Then they get mad if they ain't got steak 3 times a day.
Yeah, that's right.
Said they did 75 cents, I think, all he had. And he got 5 years, I believe, in the penitentiary and taught school all the time he's there.
Yeah.
George, you weren't here then, was you?
No, I didn't come around here in 1948.
That's later than that, I mean. I mean, it's before that.
Yeah, it's in the 30s, I imagine. They said Asheville went broke in 26.
Yeah.
That's when the crash was in Asheville. I don't know. I wasn't around yet.
I don't remember what year it was, but I was here. And that old man, they lived out of Weevil, and they come over here to get money to pay their taxes. And he told them something was going to change if they'd wait a while about taking their money out. And when it changed, sure enough, it went broke the next day.
They didn't go broke, somebody took. Them bank never go broke, somebody steal all of it.
Well, that's what that part of. You don't remember when that old man at Cherokee Bank, owned the Cherokee Bank in Murphy, and it went broke, you remember that?
Seem like I can, I was pretty young then, Jack.
One day one morning went to open the bank, and there's about five or six with a hog rifle sitting around the bank, and it says, now I know that fella's name, I believe it's Smathers. I believe his name was...
What's that thing, Peter? You know what?
Doggy, did she ever say doggy?
I don't want to. What is it, Peter?
Oh, she said, I don't know what all this stuff's all about. Well, how many of them's going home with us?
Oh, we got to. You better ride down with us.
We like to
stay around till you get weak, you can't
walk. Well, Ronnie, that'd never be.
David, come in.
Huh?
Pete, come in here and turn around and watch. David started in, right?
He went from around the right
in. You got over there with Ross, didn't
he? Peter don't know what that thing is.
He's trying to figure that out.
Yeah. Everybody go with us.
Well, all of us, y'all. Come and see
we
us.
We got to go. Y'all come see us.
Come out.
We will.
See
we will. Yeah. Y'all come. Yeah. David, you and me?
That lonely boy. That dog will catch him.
What's today's date?
I don't know. What day today?
Did you ever get mom?
No, I'm still working on you, Jack. Today's 24th, isn't it? 24th.
24th of May. 1981.
Yes, a lot of Christmas.
Jack, how old are you now?
Huh?
How old are you now?
I'm the same age. I'm like a woman. 87. Last month.
87.
87.
I think you're doing pretty good for 87.
You're 77, ain't you, Hugh?
76. I'll be 77 my next birthday.
You that old yet?
I thought I was 10 years older than you.
Well, in November, you will be.
In other words, I'm 10 years and a half.
Yeah.
Or more. A little more.
Yeah.
Look, next October I'll be 70.
You'll be 70?
Will you, Russ? 70?
I'll be 70 next October. He's taking all that down.
Yeah. And he can't deny it now.
Say, David, do you charge him according to their age?
Huh?
Yeah.
I'm thinking about it.
Yeah. I don't feel like I'm that old, Eugene.
Sometimes I feel like I'm about 90.
Hey. Well, if we didn't say that to Eugene, we wouldn't know.
Well, you said that was your best side, didn't you?
I tried to get them to leave them dishes alone. I told them I'd wash them dishes tomorrow.
We
won't be sure to catch
you. You don't have anything else to do, do you?
Well, I just washed dishes early in the morning. I'm trying to go to the garden. Well, that's not hard to wash dishes. That's something you serve.
Yeah, Dave, give David the dish. Let him wash dishes and he'll quit making these pictures.
Sadly, of course, he don't cook, so we have to do
it. David, you're supposed to be getting pictures of people in the other room.
I don't believe they cooked a bite.
That's all he got hurt out of.
Well, probably part of it, yeah. And Pam, she didn't want what we've had anyway, so. Him and Pam goes out meeting me and they'll say something, whatever we want. Hello. Or he'll bring it. Well, they'll go some and get your tossed salad or something like that.
Trinity Methodist Church in West Africa. Reverend Bill Pheagins last Sunday at this church. Thank you.
are all parts of one body. We have the same spirit, and we have all been called to the same glorious future. For us, there is only one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And we all have the same God and Father who is over us all and in us all and living through every part of us. However, Christ has given each of us special abilities, whatever he wants us to have out of his rich storehouse of gifts. Some of us have been given special ability as apostles. To others, he has given the gift of being able to preach well. Some have special ability in winning people to Christ, helping them to trust him as their Savior. Still others have a gift for caring for God's people as a shepherd does his sheep, leading and teaching them in the ways of God. Why is it that he gives us these special abilities to do certain things best? It is that God's people will be equipped to do better work for him, building up the church, the body of Christ, to a position of strength and maturity, until finally we all believe alike about our salvation and about our Savior, God's Son, and all become full-grown in the Lord, yes, to the point of being filled full with Christ. Then we will no longer be like children, forever changing our minds about what we believe, because someone has told us something different, or has cleverly lied to us and made the lie sound like the truth. Instead, we will lovingly follow the truth at all times, speaking truly, dealing truly, living truly, and so become more and more in every way like Christ, who is the head of his body, the church. Under his direction, the whole body is fitting together perfectly, and each part in its own special way helps the other parts, so that the whole body is healthy and growing and full. they got a little sobering when they got home and got to thinking back about what they had said. Most of it was true. Maybe we're just kind of with our eyes.
The
continuous effectiveness of either pastor or congregation. There should be no break or loss of the forward momentum in the transition. This happened to be the year that the bishop felt I was needed elsewhere. I was talking to one lady in Asheville whose father is a close friend of mine down in Belmont, and I asked her, I said, you know your father about me moving after 4 years here? And he said yes. Or she said yes, I told him, and he said he wasn't surprised. He knew you wouldn't keep a fool very long. You'd have to move on. It doesn't seem possible that 4 years, but 4 years ago today, June 21st, 1977, Carol and I moved into the parsonage of Trinity. And we'll never forget the warm welcome we received. From the very beginning, we felt accepted, and we felt loved. Now, I determined, you know, they say you can't please everybody, but I determined that I was going to when I got to Trinity. Those of you who have loved us have been pleased for 4 years. Those who have not loved us will be pleased during this coming week, so I pleased everybody sooner or later. On Monday, we're going to the Central United Methodist Church in Asheboro. It's a church with some 1,150 members, a heavier workload in some ways, but I will have an associate and I'll have an excellent staff to work with, and I've met part of them already. I have difficulty with the name of the associate, Charles or Chuck. Now, think how fortunate, you recognize you had to learn faith. All right, you're fortunate now, all you got to do is remember Bob Moore, some sense. Those people who asked for it have to learn Pheagins and Pheagins. So they got to work it out for them. On Tuesday, Bob will be moving into the parsonage here. He comes from Burkhead, United Methodist Church in Winston Salem. And I think there are certain observations that I want to make on this last Sunday in your midst. First of all, if you recall, the first Sunday I stood in this pulpit, I made a statement that I believe that the hand of God was in every appointment I had received. That God had a bigger hand in it than the bishop and the district superintendent. I affirm that more strongly than ever, that I think the Holy Spirit led the bishop and the cabinet to assign me to Trinity 4 years ago. And I certainly believe that the hand of God was in this move to Asheboro. Now, during these 4 years I have been here, I have attempted to be pastor to all the people of Trinity rather than any selected group. And perhaps I did not inflate some egos as I should have, as you would like, but I could never play favorites in any appointment I've ever served. I went to one place, and the lay leader of the church happened to be a dentist. And he told me quite often of the former pastor, when I called him, how he would come to the office and get him out of his office and ride and go over the problems he was having. Now, I'm not going to impose on a businessman or professional man like that and take him away from his work. And he forgot the fact that we were two different individuals. I didn't bother him at his work. I talked to him a lot at home. And he visited in our home a lot of times, and we discussed the problems of the church. But after I had left, he made the statement to some of the people that he felt like he should leave too because I had made it plain that he wasn't needed in that church. I had failed to stroke his ego as I should have, I guess. But I didn't have to have anybody to lean on. One of the greatest things, I remember something that the bishop said years ago when he was giving the charge to the young ministers just out of seminary who were coming into our conference. He said, wherever you go, God is already there, and God's people are there. How true we have found this. We were brokenhearted to leave the people of Bedford City and come to Trinity, but your love and acceptance made it so much easier. And now that we're going away from you, we are brokenhearted once again. Just think about it from this standpoint. You're losing only the two of us, but we're losing all of you. But we know that we're going to find God there, and God's people will be there. and so the pain of departing, separation, would be alleviated a great deal. I'll always remain strong in my conviction that Trinity is truly one of the great churches of Methodists. In January of 1977, before I was appointed here, we were on a retreat out of Chinalaska, and I was talking to Glenn Lackey. Glenn, one of the former district superintendents of our conference, one of the great men, really, of our conference. He's retired now. But this is a man to whom the bishops come quite often to ask advice. And Glenn made a statement to me then. We were talking, are you going to move, Bill? I said, probably will. He said, keep one thing in mind. Don't turn down Trinity. The lost members, yes, but it's climbing, it's growing, it's a good situation now. And he said, it's a great church, and how true this is. I can say I've never served a more loving, caring group of people than you. I have witnessed this, the evidences of your love and your compassion in so many areas, the way in which you have responded to needs in the congregation, in the community, and throughout the world, for that matter. The first Sunday I was here, I told you also that I wasn't here to fill anyone's shoes or to take anybody's place. I was going to be Bill Baker. I hope we got along. And you have given me freedom to be myself without any guiltiness whatsoever. And I'm thankful for that. I've had a lot of fun during these 4 years. We've laughed a lot, haven't we? And some of us have cried together too, because I've been with you in times of illness and death and examples. And I made up my mind a long time ago that I might never be a great preacher, a great administrator, a great pastor, but I could love people. And I think I am for the overflow of God's love in my heart that enables me to love the people everywhere I've ever been, very deeply. You've been understanding. You've been forgiving. I think a good example of that, just a few weeks ago, I don't know how many people realize it, but I forgot to read the scripture one day, one Sunday morning. And yet, I didn't receive a single telephone call about that. Very forgiving, very understanding. As I said a while ago, the roast that we had a couple weeks ago, it was so sober, and realized that so many things that he said about me were true. Okay, that's enough about me. Let's talk about Bob Moore a little bit. Now, Bob is a native of Redford County, and what better credentials could you ask than the fact that he was educated at Duke University and Duke Divinity School. His appointments, now you Carolina and the state man, just let that pass by. His appointments have been from 1961 to 63, St. Luke's in Morganton. From 1963 to 69, the Minister of Youth at West Market in Greensboro. 1969 to 1977, Placer and Charlotte. And since 1977, at Birkhead and Winston Salem. Now, keep one thing in mind. Bob is not feeble. He is not a plumber. He's Bob Moore. We are two different individuals. We have different gifts. We have different priorities. And Paul pointed this out so well in our scripture lesson this morning. He was writing to the Christians at Ephesus. And notice again how he starts out. Be patient with one another, making allowance for each other's faults because of your love. Now, you've been patient with me in spite of my faults. Practice that same type of charity with Bob. Then Paul goes on to say, Christ has given each of us special abilities. Whatever he wants us to have out of his rich storehouse of gifts. Notice the way he describes some of these gifts. To some of us have been given special ability as apostles. To others, he has given the gift of being able to preach well. Somehow special ability in winning people to Christ. Still others have a gift for caring for God's people as a shepherd does his sheep, leading and teaching them in the ways of God. Now keep this scripture in mind when you are tempted to make comparisons. We're different persons, as I said. We'll do things differently. And in a lot of ways, last week, Bob's going to be real strong. And I know he's going to hear Bill Fagin and he's sick of the name, but knowing him, he'll grin and bear it. Just don't try to tell it how I did things, because when he gets here, he's going to wonder if I've done anything during these past 4 years. I always remember the story of one of the church, and he followed a preacher by the name of Robert Stein. He got there, and every day he heard Brother Stone. Preacher Stone did this. Preacher Stone was just the greatest of the young people. Preacher Stone looked after the elderly and shut in. Preacher Stone. He brought something up at a board meeting. Preacher Stone would have done it different. And this is all he heard. He said he got to the point where he thought Stone could probably walk on water if he ever tried to. And so finally he made some motion at the board meeting, and someone spoke up and said, well, Preacher Stone would have done it the other way. And this was the straw that broke the camel's back. And he got up and he said, I have an announcement to make. For your information, the Stone Age has ended. And so the Pheagin age has ended at Trinity. Bob is coming here believing in you and in Trinity Church. He knows something of the history of the church. He knows what a terrific heritage you have. He comes with the belief that you're a loving, caring group of people. He has proved himself in the appointments he served, a very capable preacher, an excellent administrator, and a fine pastor. But always keep in the back of your mind, here is a servant of Christ. He's a man of God, and he will be preaching out of a biblical knowledge. He will be preaching out of a varied experience. Now, maybe I'll mention this, but fools rush in sometimes. A friend of mine went to his first appointment before he was ever married. And he said that he'd been there about 3 weeks, and a little lady in the church invited him to have lunch with her and her two daughters. And he said they ate the lunch after church on Sunday morning, and said that she said, now you girls wash the dishes, I want to talk to the preacher. She took him into the living room and sat him down, and she turned to him and said, all right, which one of you like the best? Now, Bob is a single man. This is his way of life. And I'm sure that in all of his appointments, a lot of matchmaking has been attempted. And some of you will not resist the temptation to play cute. Don't be, I won't say it is for this reason. You're going to, I know that. You're human beings. Don't be disappointed if it doesn't work out. Now, and I say this in the newsletter, give me a Bob the support you can give to me. There's truly a great future ahead for Trinity. I'm so thankful that I've had this opportunity for 4 years to serve one of the greatest churches of Methodism. And I always believe that. Some of you have put up with me on the golf course, and we're still friends. That's great. Some of you that I've grown extremely close to, that I'll never forget. You'll be friends across the years. Our ties are so strong. And I want to say a special thank you to the choir. You know, all of these 4 years, I have never been disappointed on Sunday morning by the choir. And a special thank you to June Smith, the most cooperative, dedicated music director anyone could ever have. And I'm so grateful for June. And I'll guarantee you one thing, that if we lose an organist and choir director at Ashboro, I'm going to try some proselyte. I've been very fortunate to have an excellent staff working during these years. Rosemary has been just fantastic. I'm so grateful. To all the officers of the church, a special thank you for the way you supported the programs of the church and supported me in my ministry. And I think I can sum up 4 years, really, despite all of the heartaches we've had together. You remember a sermon title I used a few weeks ago, I don't remember, it's all exactly when. But I think this would sum up 4 years of Trinity, and the words of that sermon title. year, have a good time. Gone. It's been great. I'm going to ask you to be close to service in this way today. But I need your prayers, and I appreciate you very much. My Lord needs your prayers as he comes in. And I'm going to ask you to play something on the organ. And if you would like to come here to the altar today, sort of rededication on your part to your church and to your God, and pledging your support to Bob Lord, and asking God's blessings on you. Stay here as long as you like. You return to your seat and others can come take your place. Bless you in the church.
People that come in and help.
Well, you just really made it.
Hey, Jane.
Look quick for your church,
baby. Hey, man.
Oh, no.
Half of them so far. Oh, so far it's just been one laugh after another. I've got to talk to you about this.
Who's that over there? We can take any more boars in this church or not.
Oh,
I'm
Where's the potato salad without the onion? This is it here.
In the smaller bean.
You like some ham, yeah, Miss?
That's good.
Okay. Now, what do you want to drink, Miss Riley?
A bite. Captain, we've got Coke.
A bite. What you want? A bite. What is that?
Potato. You want tea? Or a little bit of Pepsi or something like that. Tea or Pepsi or something like that.
You want coffee?
Drink Pepsi sometimes.
Is that good? We got coffee. You want coffee, Miss Rose?
She drinks Pepsi.
I don't drink coffee hard there.
You do. So these are kind of hot, like they've got pepper.
Well, I don't know because they're seasoned and ready when I got them. They come in 6-pound package bags, you know, for wholesale
restaurants. Don't tell Barbara to give me a napkin.
I thought they were real good.
Don't get me a napkin.
There it is,
Whitney.
Here,
Whitney,
bring that tongue
in. Now,
Whitney, thank you. If you want more, I'll get you more.
Here, take this one to Granny.
Have all the eggs you want.
Come here. Take this to Granny.
Let it come out over and fix your plate.
What cooks your own?
Would you like me to fix your own?
No, I'm the phone plate.
Now I need my nose wax. Sweet young.
This is August the 23rd, 1981. Everyone wanted to go up the mountain but me. But I had to drive, and here we are back down at the river.
What river?
Everybody wanted to go up the mountain but me, but he had to drive.
French Broad, right? Is that right?
You're right.
Right over here. Which one has onions in it, Mother?
You like that?
This one right here.
Which has it?
Uh-oh. Oh, sugar. It's going to be all right. It's all right.
It's fine.
It's okay. It's all right.
What happened to her?
She died.
Whitney, bring Whitney up here. Come here. I want
come baby up here, to baby.
Come on, Pete, sit down and suck.
Tell them all about the rock.
Rock.
And the creek. We threw the rock. What are we doing?
This is the grandchild. That's the great-grandchild. That's my son.
Okay, you can get down and walk away if you feel like it.
That's my great-grandchild, too.
That's enough. That's hers, too. Okay. Get Joey over there now.
Great, great, great.
Go
on.
Have another.
Teach her how to throw it.
Do it like this. I'll show you. Like this.
So, Mommy taught me to throw it like that.
Throw it hard.
Oh, that's not hard.
Yeah.
What Mommy told her.
It went in. Yeah.
Ooh. My heart dropped.
Oh. I just decided I'd take it out.
Still filming?
Yeah.
Hey, Grandpa. Hey there, say hey, Grandpa.
Hi, Whitney. Well, you might practice on the focus in just a little bit before you do.
Now, what do I do?
To start recording, all you do is pull to push the trigger.
Okay.
As long as that light, see the light on the lower right?
Uh-huh. Well, it says under.
That means it doesn't have quite enough light. But now when you start recording, there'll be a light on the left corner.
It says record. Well, it's green,
huh? You don't have to hold the trigger down for it to.
Okay, but where is the focus thing?
Well, you can focus it by hand, or you can use this zoom thing right over here. Now you can.
Okay, let me see what it's like by hand.
Come here. Come here and see me. Get up there. Get up there.
Can you focus it?
Now you want some cake now.
Yeah.
It was not on the
What did she call it? Apple.
What's now is it?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Somebody else
is
it.
Bite.
As long as that green light's on, it's paper. Hey Whitney. Hey.
Get one close up of her face.
I want to see that face.
Get one close up of that dirty face.
Where's my girl? Where's Gaines' girl?
Hey, Granny, look here. Look at Daddy. Look at Daddy's making you.
Whitney.
Say hi there.
Hi there.
I got a pretty face. All right. Top down. As soon as you hug my neck. As soon as I get a hug. Good. Now, as soon as I get
you gonna give him a hug?
Yeah, good hug.
Give him a good hug.
Yeah, good hug.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, goodness. Thank you. Damn. All right. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye.
Did you hear up on the mountain say bye, Clyde?
Hello. Okay.
Come here. Hey, boy, Clyde. What do you just mean to cross here? Smile, you're on candy camera. Smile.
I didn't have a watch. She had chips on how
we were making
dirty face. So you tell her, you see her. What I was doing is that I was thinking to come that fast. That I was walking out of here. I was looking at that girl. I was that late. She was like, no.
No, that's dirty.
It's my friend, you're on TV.
I'll smile again.
Daddy, I'm mowing.
Go out there and get a whole lot out there. Not there.
How many do you have?
Where'd it go, Whitney? Where'd it go?
I saw one the other day. Probably 10 and a half. And it's never took a... It can't stand up, hardly yet.
Yeah, I know he was here
early. Did you walk early? Joe did too, didn't he? She's as bad.
Open your mouth, Whitney.
She's as bad as Grandy is to groom.
Okay. They probably can get a picture of that.
What?
Whitney, open your mouth.
Whitney? Whitney?
Whitney. Look at Granddaddy.
Whitney, where did it go?
Where'd it go?
Where'd it go?
Huh? Let's say you tell him.
Whitney? Don't eat the...
Dirty.
Where'd it go?
Whitney, did you know this is your birthday? This is your birthday.
Sort of.
September the what, 9th? 1981. You're 18 months old today.
She 18 months old? Well, it seems like it's been 6 months since we was over there.
A party?
Time is flying by.
Where'd it go, Whitney?
Dirty. Let's see, we were over. We used to go
with
Mary Jane and David once a year. Since Whitney got here, we've been a dozen times this year already.
Oh, that's
she picked up a little rock. Gosh.
Takes a lot of now, energy. The
rest of us can run around like that, but you've got no reason to eat it either.
I've eaten so much, I think I'm going to have to go to bed.
Yeah.
What are you picking up?
That's hurting you, I know.
What are you picking up?
She's not even looking mouth. Okay.
What's that?
Nose.
Where's my mouth? That's your mouth. Where's my eye? Here. Well, where's my hand?
Whitney? Whitney.
Look up there.
Well, show them where Granddaddy's girl is.
Right there.
That's right.
Right there.
Oh, well, we'll let it down. Before it gets up, it has to get down.
Where's Whitney's foot?
Uh-oh. Dropped the rock. Mommy's sorry.
You just bring the can over here. Huh? Bring the can.
Thank you, she says.
Clyde's not even saying thank you.
Is your ear hurting?
Is it itching?
Is it itching? Is it itch? Thank you.
Well, now you see that stone with the yellow jacket. He said that like this 10 to death.
All right, take it. No, Dave Bryson did, I guess. But he's like,
Mother, you have any Adolph's meat tenderizer?
No.
Well, get some, keep it. That's what the doctor said to put on it.
What?
Adolph's meat tenderizer, and it keeps it from getting sore and swelling and that sort of thing. She wouldn't let us put any on her, but.
Chew tobacco
too. Yeah, Papa used to put tobacco on me when I'd go with him in the field and get stung with pack saddle.
That's the hurtiest things ever been.
I know it. I said I'd rather be stung with anything.
I it would too.
It just makes chills run all over you when you get stung with another thing.
That's a busy girl.
Well, that one told me that he'd lost his stinger and I picked him up and he had. He backed up. No, yes, I got the best out there on the other one right there.
Okay, come
over here on this side. I've
been in each for a week. Huh.
I bet she get some of that and keep it.
Put your hand up right
there.
Whitney, look at your knee. Your knee's dirty.
It didn't stop it from scratching.
Shoo! Dirty.
Both of them are dirty. The other one's dirty too.
A bit of water will wash that off though, won't it? You tell she's skin to you.
Well, I tell you one thing, you won't skin nobody else.
You got him, huh?
I got him.
She's showing Barbara.
And I got all these books.
What do you want me to do with these rocks?
You were really.
What do you want me to do with them? Put them in there. Let me put them in there. Here, son.
I'd like to take her up there and let her look down that wall.
She'll be going up for soon.
She'll probably go up this side.
I started to say she probably won't be up there looking down or be from down here going up.
Every time it comes here, always goes out there and climbs on that wall. Tommy Slager and what was that other name? Tommy and Tommy Clayton come over here and climb up and down that wall.
Joey's just missing it.
Well, no matter how big a handle I get, she'll keep on. She gets every one of them in. Wait a minute, let me get a big handful. That's a good one right there. Uh-oh, you're stealing them. Now, I know good and well, young, and you can't get all of them in that hand. Airplane, yeah, right there it is. You see it? Up there. You see it? What is it?
Let's see if there's a tree.
Hey, Whitney, what's that?
Ow.
Turtle? Turtle? No, don't put your hand over there at his face. That's a little
turtle.
Don't put your hand on it. Lay it down. Let it walk. It'll walk in a minute. Whitney. Well, don't do that. Don't do that. He won't ever come out. You close up, won't ever come out. Leave him alone and he'll walk. No, don't bother him. Leave him alone and he'll come walking along in a minute.
I think, well, you're going to lose your britches, aren't you, Mindy, I think. You're getting like Dan Bryson Hooper. Your stomachs are getting so big, your britches won't stay up. You know, Dan Bryson going up the street right before you came out. And he had fur pants like this on, and there's way down here in that stuff.
I haven't seen him. I don't know if I know him or not. I haven't seen him.
Come here.
That's that beer, isn't?
You mean he drinks like the rest of them did?
Why, sure.
Well, he used to be.
He got off of it.
Come back over here.
Come back over
here.
I took the preacher's little bag of grapes this morning down there. I told my son, now, preacher, if you want any wine, you can make it. And then he says, if there's a hole in the bottom of the keg, God, it'll be your fault, not mine. No, boy, he did all.
Back over here, I thought you'd fall out that little door. Shot.
I think that turtle wants a little of the bottle.
Oh, gosh, you better come kind of give it some, bud.
Where are you going?
There's bees out there, honey. Don't go out there. Come here, don't go out there where the bees is.
I'll tell you what you need to do sometime, is take all them old newspapers out of the back floorboard of your car. Them things be in there, let's baby plumb out and look. Like, oh, what's your name?
Oh, my goodness, let's go wash that bottle. What you say, it's been going around and everything else. She's like Joe, and Joe Gass is like the rest of the buildings.
Go over and tell Pipe to fix it. Go tell Pipe to fix it. Got that toe out and can't get it back, can't. How's that? Is that better? That's better.
Can you go walk it?
Gee, that'll bite you.
No, it won't. Don't stir that.
Ow! Ow! Well, put him down and then he'll come out in a few minutes.
Take it and show Daddy.
Take it and show Daddy. Come here.
Did you hide it? Oh, there's his foot. He shut up and didn't get his foot in.
Toe.
Is that toe out again? I think you're just doing that. There you go.
Thank you.
up there. Come on, Pheagins up there. Go sit in there with Granddaddy. What is this?
Nanu.
Nanu. And what's that right there?
Apple.
Uh-huh. Nanu and apple. That's right. Well, you're going to have to stand down there just a minute and let Granny finish, okay?
Granddaddy, Whitney.
What are you doing, Whitney?
Whitney, what you doing?
Picking rocks.
Picking rocks.
A bee? No. I don't believe we saw a bee.
There's one right beside you just a second ago. Yellow jacket. Oh, no bees. No sugar, there's no bees.